We now know the names of the plane crash victims. Among the deceased, a father and his infant daughter.
Yeah. Hey, guys. So police just reopened the street here in front of the home where crews have literally spent hours removing very large chunks of the actual plane. Go ahead and take a look behind me, though. You can see all of the damage from where the plane made impact, actually damaging three houses on its way down and setting this one that you're looking at right here on fire, critically injuring a 72-year-old woman, Mary Quintana. The crash caused a number of other injuries and claimed the lives of three. The pilot, Lee Wyckoff, and his 9-month-old daughter, Coral, both died, while Rebecca Wyckoff, the wife and mother, is currently in critical condition. Milda Shibonis also lost her life during this crash. Her 12-year-old daughter was on the plane as well. She was treated and released from the hospital. Another 2-year-old is still in critical condition with burns to his arms and legs. We are working on reaching out to those families, and we will be providing you some statements and some interviews with them coming up tonight at 9. There is a fundraising page that's been started for Milda to help cover those funeral costs. You can find a link to that on our website. Live in West Jordan, Elle Thomas, Fox 13 News, Utah.
Elle, thank you. And now a quick recap of that crash. A small engine aircraft left South Valley Regional Airport crashing into a West Jordan neighborhood around 1:30 yesterday afternoon. 6 people were on board, 2 adults and an infant died in the crash. 1 child walked away unharmed and 2 were taken to the hospital in critical condition. A woman at the home that was hit was also hospitalized. Fox 13 will continue to follow any updates from this crash as the NTSB investigates. You can find the latest here, on air, online, and on our social media.